Technology will be the linchpin for Southeast Asia's post-pandemic recovery. That's why Southeast Asian countries should band together to create their own regional technology hub so as to position the region for a new digital age of prosperity. Masatsugu Asakawa, president of the Asian Development Bank, said this at the inaugural Southeast Asian Development Symposium, which was held virtually. Lo Min Min tells us more.
From virtual meetings to online food deliveries, the COVID-19 pandemic has hastened the adoption of technology as countries around the world entered lockdowns. In Indonesia, for instance, which is still struggling with a rising number of COVID-19 cases, millions of students around the country have been forced to adapt to remote learning, while staff meetings are held virtually. And because of that, the Education Ministry estimates budget savings of up to 30%.
People consistently underestimate how much money is saved by doing meetings over Zoom. As soon as none of our conferences, meetings were held through travel, hotels, etc., the sheer amount of efficiency that you can get from a monetary perspective is more than significant.
But the shift to digital technologies has also exposed a digital divide, and access to technology has become another source of inequality for the poor and marginalized. So the Asian Development Bank says it's imperative that governments make the internet accessible and affordable as they become vital for accessing basic services like healthcare and education.
It is important that countries address regional disparities and ensure more equitable access to technology. For this, we must close the digital divide and expand existing investments in digital infrastructure by building more and higher quality mobile broadband infrastructure and ensuring affordable internet access and coverage.
As the pace of digital transformation accelerates, tech firms have received a COVID-19 boost. And Mr. Asakawa says Southeast Asian nations should prepare to tap on technology for a post-pandemic recovery.
It is imperative for countries to help aggregate a financial, academic and business ecosystem that can create a cutting-edge industrial base where SME congregate, just like Silicon Valley, Shenzhen and Kyoto. Doing so will help set the stage for technology-based growth of the future, and it will position Southeast Asia for a new digital age of prosperity.
The one-day Southeast Asia Development Symposium attracted more than 1,700 high-level government officials, private sector representatives, and other stakeholders from 57 countries.